Hey guys, I'm Erik Voss, and a lot of you have been asking about the ending of the movie Split. That's M. Night Shyamalan's latest thriller starring James MacAvoy as a man with multiple personalities. And because this is a video about the ending of a Shyamalan film, even though the movie's been out for enough time really for you to see it, I am obligated to say major spoilers ahead. Seriously, I'm about to ruin this movie for you. Okay, so the biggest thing people are talking about with Split is a super mysterious final scene with a TV news report about the Horde, the supervillainy nickname given to Kevin Crumb, James McAvoy's character. A woman tries to remember the funny name given to a crazy guy in a wheelchair they put away 15 years ago. And then there's a surprise cameo by Bruce Willis's David Dunn from Shyamalan's 2000 movie Unbreakable. He says Mr. Glass, who was Samuel L. Jackson's character in that movie. So since all of M. Night Shyamalan's movies end with some kind of big twist, the twist of this movie is, despite presenting itself as a horror thriller about three girls held prisoner by a mental patient, Split is actually the origin story of a super villain, the Horde, who exists in the same cinematic universe as Unbreakable. And if you haven't seen that movie either, why are you watching this video? What are you doing on YouTube at all? Go watch more movies and stop whining that we're spoiling life for you. But as far as M. Night Shyamalan twists go, this one's pretty cool. So who is Kevin Wendell Crumb, aka the Horde? Shyamalan has explained in interviews that the character of Kevin Crumb, the Horde, was actually in the original script for Unbreakable. That story was going to be centered around three characters, with Kevin Crumb joining David Dunn, an indestructible man who can read people's crimes by touching them, and Elijah Price, Mr. Glass, a physically fragile but extremely intelligent man who, in a sense, created David by orchestrating a number of terrorist events. But as Shyamalan developed the story for Unbreakable, he realized it worked better as a movie about duality, the balance between good and evil, between being broken and unbreakable. And it was just too hard to balance the Horde in that story. So he removed the character, but he held on to him, hoping to one day introduce him in an Unbreakable sequel, which he said has been the number one thing fans have been asking him about. So what is Kevin's disorder slash power? I actually think the movie was pretty clear about this. There were, after all, like 10 scenes with Dr. Fletcher explaining to us dissociative identity disorder and parapsychology. So basically, Kevin Crumb suffered abuse as a boy, causing his mind to split into 23 distinct personalities, including Dennis, Barry, Patricia, Hedwig, and a number of others. And the film describes them all as living in a dark room with one chair, and that whoever sits in the chair at any given moment takes the spotlight, controlling Kevin's mind and body. Now, the story grounds all the science fiction in a powerful emotional theme, that people who are broken are more evolved, more fit to survive. An extension of the belief in psychology that suffering is a key component to the human experience. Or as Kelly Clarkson puts it, "What doesn't kill you makes you stronger." Now, Split as a film literalizes this concept with the Beast. So what is the Beast? The Beast is a 24th identity in Kevin's mind based on the animals in the zoo that Kevin works in. So it makes sense that the zoo animals would inspire the Beast's abilities. The speed of a cheetah, the tough skin of a rhinoceros, the ability to climb walls like a lizard, and the super strength of a gorilla or bear or someone on PCB. I don't know. So Dennis, Patricia, and Hedwig dominate Kevin's mind to give the Beast the reins to Kevin, because they believe that the Beast represents the next stage of human evolution and will devour those who are pure, basically people who haven't been broken through some sort of trauma. And that is why the Beast eats the other two girls, but leaves Casey alone at the end. He can tell from her scars that she's broken too. Remember, flashbacks throughout the film revealed that she was abused by her uncle, which interestingly also involved an association with animals. He and dressed with her as they pretended to be wild beasts. And that mental association between traumatic abuse and animalistic behavior might mean we'll see Casey come back in the next film with similar powers to Kevin, maybe her own horde of split personalities and her own beast. Which brings me back to that diner scene. What does this mean for a Split, Unbreakable sequel, or cinematic universe? Now, some people are suggesting that Bruce Willis's David Dunn showing up at the end of Split might mean all of M. Night Shyamalan's movies are connected in one giant cinematic universe. Like maybe we'll get a Shyamalan Avengers with another Sam Jackson character assembling a new super team to take down the Horde, including an unbreakable man, maybe Casey's own Horde, a kid who can see dead people, the aliens from Signs, the Narf from Lady in the Water, the wind, or trees? Was it trees? Wow, that started as a cool idea, then got real stupid real fast. Still, I think we can all agree, huge missed opportunity here, M. Night. If you're gonna use a final scene to set up a superhero sequel, Sam Jackson is obviously the man for the job. Just like throw an eye patch on Mr. Glass and then have him roll into the diner. But before you get too excited, Shyamalan has indicated that this scene is just setting up one movie.
If people enjoy Split, then we'll do the final conversation about this.
So apparently Shyamalan has a 10-page outline for this Unbreakable sequel, if it ever happens. And from the sound of it, it might show David Dunn facing off against the Horde that has overtaken Kevin Crumb, with possibly Mr. Glass and Casey coming back into the story. And there's already some interesting connections here, with both Mr. Glass and Kevin Crumb being defined by the fact that they're broken. And in case this hasn't occurred to you yet, the words Split and Unbreakable are opposites of each other. So it sounds like Shyamalan is intending to revisit some of these duality themes that made Unbreakable so great. And I gotta admit, I'm pretty excited to see where Shyamalan goes with this. Remember, M. Night Shyamalan was, for many years, considered the next Steven Spielberg. And The Sixth Sense, Unbreakable, and Signs were all pretty great in my opinion. I just think the guy rose too fast and got too attached to some annoying director gimmicks like twist endings and director cameos. But anyone who loves superhero movies should appreciate Shyamalan's work in Unbreakable. It was a grounded, thoughtful, original superhero origin story that came out long before its time, when brighter, flashier comic adaptations like X-Men and Spider-Man began to define the genre. Now, Shyamalan's career obviously went in a very different direction. In fact, his attitude when it came to adapting beloved source material in Avatar The Last Airbender justifiably lost him a lot of points in the nerd world. Meanwhile, people like Christopher Nolan really took over as the go-to directors for realism and philosophy in the superhero genre. And now Marvel Studios and Zack Snyder and Simon Kinberg at Fox have really taken over the cinematic superhero industry. But I'm really interested to see M. Night Shyamalan return to form and dust off mythology from when he was a younger storyteller and show us his version of a superhero sequel. It could be really great. It could be really bad. It might have a stupid-ass twist ending with trees. But Split was good enough that I'm willing to give it a chance. Two amazing actors playing two great characters, or I should say 25 characters technically. McAvoy was insanely great in this movie. And Sam Jackson, guys, I'm in. Okay, let me know what you think in the comments. Did you like Split? Do you think Unbreakable needs a sequel? Has M. Night Shyamalan lost your trust completely? Let me know what you think. And if you like this video, please hit like and subscribe to New Rockstars. And if you really like us, you can contribute to us on Patreon. A big thanks to all of our donors, with a big shout out to Matthew Salvas. You can hit me up on Twitter at EA Voss with any thoughts or questions you have about Split, or you can follow New Rockstars on Twitter at New Rockstars for updates on our videos. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.